What has Mandela meant to you, personally?
Oh, personally, he's been a wonderful friend to me. You know, when we were working together, we were both presidents of our countries. We had actually had a lot of business to do. We often had to do it in telephone calls where it was very late in America and very early in South Africa. And I always tried to do the late side because out of deference to him. But he didn't call me a single time, not once, when he didn't ask about Hillary and Chelsea. And if it wasn't too late, he'd ask me to go get Chelsea, bring her to the phone, and ask her about her homework, was she keeping up? You know, so I saw in him something that I tried not to lose in myself, which is no matter how much responsibility he had, he remembered he was a person first. And then I learned a lot about living from him, about living with adversity, living with setbacks, living with disappointments, and living without anger. So quite apart from all the magnificent contributions he made to free his country and to inspire the world, I learned a lot about life from him.
Do you think you taught him anything?
I doubt it. I was a pretty good politician. I might have helped him, but he was a pretty good politician when I met him. I don't know. We did a lot together. I liked the fact that he was loyal to the people who stayed with the ANC during all those tough years. And I liked the fact that he tried to make every young South African feel that they could be part of the future. I'll never forget, a friend of mine was a minister, he's still around, an American minister, who was supposed to shake hands with Madiba in the airport once. And so he was watching him walk across the lobby, and he went up to a little girl who happened to be white, blonde hair, and blue-eyed, and he asked her, do you know who I am? He said, yes, you're Mr. Mandela, you're my president. And he said, you can be president if you study hard. You know, I mean, he was always trying to bring people in.
I think you've said that when you're with him, you feel like you want to walk a little bit taller.
You do. The great gift he had was not to be a great person, but to make you want to be a great person. He made everybody else want to be bigger. And you're always thinking, well, if he could do all this, if he could endure all this, and he could still have a smile on his face and a song in his heart, who am I to whine about whatever's going on in my life? You know, he made everybody want to be bigger. And I think it's an uncommon gift that I somehow hope we'll all find a way to keep alive forever.